Thank you. And calm down, animals. An Emmy-winning actor, he's the star of the Lifetime movie An American Daughter, and he's the host of the J. Thomas Morning Show on Clear Channels, Jam and 105 in New York, and he's also quite a hottie. J. Thomas.
Hey.
Ladies and gentlemen. Hello. You are, sir.
How are you? Everybody again? How are you?
Good.
Good.
This election, I'm getting depressed because I keep reading about why people are voting, and you know it's changed now. Gore's behind again. Gore was way behind, and then the convention came. He kissed his wife and stuck his tongue down her throat, and he was ahead. And then Bush went on Oprah and kissed. He's ahead. And I think we have to take the vote away from women. I swear to God.
Wait a minute.
I only say this because a woman in my office said that. A woman read this today. The smartest person I know, not just woman. She said, women shouldn't vote. She said that because, and the Gallup poll guy said, women, he said they bounce around depending on the last thing they heard on the news. So, you know, I mean, they get out of traffic tickets. Why do they need to vote, too?
Oh, ticket.
You never got out of a traffic
never.
Ticket?
Never.
Oh,
no. Never,
please,
ever.
Try
ever.
Another one on me.
First of all.
No, I never have. Look,
first of all, I think if Tipper comes out topless, the men vote goes up. Also, right? Well, maybe not. Maybe the men vote goes down.
I know something will go down.
But, Bill, I think really that. I think that really, men
like
are
when
just.
He said something will go down. I didn't like it.
Well, no, I didn't really. I have to admit.
Okay.
But I was trying to ignore it.
I understand.
No, but Bill, really, I think that there are just as many uninformed men as uninformed women.
You're right. I was being facetious.
I know.
The question
I know.
But not Bill, Bill, yeah. Does it matter who wins? I've been around since Warren Harding.
No, you have.
Yes, I have.
Warren Harding?
Warren G. Harding?
Warren, that was the 20s.
I was born in the 20s.
You weren't voting.
You know how, but I was there.
You were there in
there
the 20s.
There were influences.
Really?
Naturally. And
I took such a little interest in electoral politics when I was three.
But here, we got Republicans, Democrats, Republicans. What's changed?
Oh, I think that it makes a major impact. I think it makes a major impact who wins this election. Because we have two candidates who are very different on a lot of issues. Abortion, for example. Things like the environment or gun control.
Right.
All of these things, they're very different.
But listen to the way they all say, I'm
going to
fight for this. What does that mean?
Well, it's turned into a total contest because they've gotten away from the issues and now it's who can kiss this
no,
butt here.
I don't think that's
who can
true.
Get win these people over, who
it
can
is.
Be on
it's
MTV,
a lot of...
who's on Choose or Lose, because the thing is even they're on those those programs and they're getting out there and they're using those forms of media to get to those younger, my age, the 20s, the 25-year-olds that really
they're not
don't
voting
care.
Anyway.
They're
those
not
kids
really
aren't voting
anyway.
There was a poll today. MTV had a poll.
Yep.
What? MTV?
People
choose or lose.
There is a voting audience.
They don't vote. They don't vote.
They
the
don't
lowest,
vote.
The lowest voting.
Why do you think...
18 to 24 is the lowest voting.
Why do you think that Gore and those guys are down there kissing the ass of senior citizens? Because they vote. Those wrinkly asses get kissed.
Right. Right, exactly. Well, you know, I'll tell you another thing. If the people that say they want welfare, the people that need Social Security, if the poor people in the United States would register to vote, the Republicans would never be in again. They just don't vote in mass. Oh, if you believe in choice, and if you ever
like
want to get a welfare
choice,
check again...
Like school choice, for example, young people... under
show me a school you can get into for $1,500. That's what they want to give you.
Bergen Community College.
No,
well,
school choice is working, Jay.
But
in Milwaukee, school choice is working. We've had school choice for 10 years there.
Where?
And it's in Milwaukee. And it is making an impact.
And not in L.A. Not in Orange County. The schools there are... No,
what's wrong with Milwaukee? You
tell
me, Mr.
Hollywood. I would never live in Milwaukee. I'm sure it's a nice place.
But besides the point...
I I should call my wife and say, let's put the kids in public school in Milwaukee and just wait for the reaction.
We would have these on TV if there was the education on how to vote and what to look for in a candidate. If that was in schools and it was taught and people focused on people younger
talking about.
Listen to this.
They wouldn't have to go to why people vote.
And it's not just women. You're right. Listen, there's an article about 2 weeks ago in the New York Times. It's about the people who are getting their ass kissed. You know, these are the people who are undecided. Listen to how people make up their minds. For some people, the shifts have sprung from very small events. Their change in thinking emerged from the smallest of details, like a well-placed bottle of wine in a televised home video of Mr. Gore that made Josh Comedy suddenly decide that Mr. Gore was fun, someone I felt was like my dad. Rebecca Hebke was more indifferent until she heard one of Mr. Gore's peoples use the term living wage, which sent her into paroxysms of rage. She decided to vote for Mr. Bush. I don't like that term, no way. I don't want to give away all my taxes to have other people set up for life, which, of course, is what the minimum wage does. Oh. It sets you up for life.
Oh, yeah, that's why they have to keep going up every year.
It's the easy street bill, you know.
One of my daughters went to school in Milwaukee.
Thank you, Mr. Leonard. How is she doing?
Oh, she went to Marquette. Oh. We're talking about the public school system for $1,500 if they give you a voucher.
I thought I'd throw that in. You threw Marquette in?
Well,
but
I got the job this way. It's a commercial,
Milwaukee,
and I have
great.
To throw it all the time. Opened on Milosevic, that bastardly bomb out of Kosovo last year. He looks like he lost his election over there in Yugoslavia. He's trying to force a runoff with his challenger, and he is really running scared because today he has an advisor's call up and try to get him booked on Oprah. So, you know, he's... Field works are not going to carry the first presidential debate. NBC is going to show a baseball playoff game. Fox has regular programming. And Bush, I don't know how bright this guy is. He said today he plans to watch the playoff game and tape the debate, so don't tell me who wins. All right, we started talking about women in the election. How many of you get the Journal of Sex Research? Do you get that, Jay?
Yeah,
I get it. I have home delivery now. Well, they made their way into one of the papers last week. I think it was USA Today. It said that here's what happened. Here's what they discovered. That they did a survey of 200 college women and found that a third of women in college, when they're looking pretty good, worry about what they look like during sex, and the men don't worry about that. And, of course, there's that usual drum beating about, you know, it's a paternalistic society and it's a bad body image thing. I don't think that's why women worry about what they look like during sex. I think it's because they present a lie before they go out at night.
They present a lie?
Yeah, I mean, they're all pushed in and propped up and painted on. They have so many doohickeys and gizmos and, you know, I mean, how they actually look is just a beginning. It's a lump of clay. How are they going to arrange it is a whole different story. And then they have to, like, unravel, and then that's why I think they
do that for a reason, though.
Well, it starts with the guy says, you want the light on or off?
I know. And you know what? I say close the car door and get that light off.
No. I think men are much more shallow than that. They could care less while it's going on. It's what women should worry about is the excuses they start making why they have to leave. They'll be going, like, oh God, look at that time. You know, it's like, they're like out of there so fast.
Yeah.
That's the complaint I always hear from women is like, why do you have to go? And not from now, but from years ago.
Yeah,
I worry when I get a manicure before I masturbate. That's how worried I am about how I look. But, I mean, that was always the great worry.
Seriously, every time I hear your voice on the radio, I'm going to remember that.
All right.
Seriously, though, I think that this is the result.
And I'll be thinking of you, too.
Hold it a second. There it is.
We're not paying attention to the virgin. What do you have to say?
Yeah.
Virgin, I made the commitment to wait until marriage, and it's the best choice I've made.
that this
is a
result
perversion,
of a
perversion, but go ahead.
Right back at ya.
Suppose you sleep with the husband guy after you've waited and you the first night and it's completely freaky and he's a complete weirdo, but you never tested him
right.
out prior to the night.
You always take a car.
You gotta test drive a car.
You gotta kick the tires.
But human beings are not like
you would be like driving a Ferrari for me.
Them, but
I think the lawsuit is coming after the show.
Let's go to the VW Beetle. What are you talking about?
You're still smarting over that choice thing, aren't you?
I am.
No, but seriously, I think it's a result that women are having sex with guys who, you know, haven't made a commitment to them, and they feel that rather than sharing something loving and special with them, they feel that they have to impress the guy.
I completely disagree. Yes. That's exactly why women are self-conscious. Yeah, I did Playboy, but every single picture that was in there, perfect lighting, 2.5 hours of makeup, airbrushing, the perfect clothes, the perfect
picture.
Right.
Not having
you're
sex.
Just a
that's
cow in person,
look
let me
that's
tell you.
That's what men look at. But honestly, if you've got a boyfriend and he's got that magazine, or you're on a date and you come over to his house and you see that, you know that he thinks, when you have these seductive looks that, honestly, I don't know where they come from, they get them on film.
Right.
But, you
because
know,
you make
men,
them on film.
Men, they think, I can't measure up to that. I've modeled for 6 years, and girls think that it's a standard to be what it is on a magazine. This is not reality.
Right.
No,
and you know, and it's a false
that's
advertising.
Not
and what you said about those
but
looks,
that's fantasy.
Those pouty looks
right.
in magazines, those pouty looks. I was looking at this, something like that, with a bunch of guys once. No, it was like the maximum hottest 100
right.
women in the world, and like every woman had that look. And I remember one guy said, you know, even if you could get that girl, which we couldn't, she'd never make that look for you.
I'll make that look. No, but seriously,
I don't know what to say to that.
I've never been stopped.
No, it's what you see. You see on covers of magazines, on the Vogue, on, you know, I'm in Maxim this month, and someone comes up to me and goes, how does your skin look like that? I said, that's Photoshop. And she goes, no, but really, I said, you know, they want these women to look so amazingly
right.
beautiful, but know that there's so much that goes into it. And they think that, well, I can't
right.
measure up to that. I can't
I can
look like Giselle.
That without
I can't
the lighting
walk
here
the
tonight,
runway.
You
I'm
look a lot
size
like Bruce
four.
Dern.
I've been given a gift, and I'm using it to make a career, but I'm saying those that aren't feel that this is what people want, and that's what they strive for, and they set.
And Elmore, you look like
really
you're about to.
Elmore's
about to.
Wait,
Elmore looks
hold
like
it.
He's about to spew something very, very profound.
All right.
I'm the smartest one here. I'd like to.
Yeah, yeah.
I was going to ask if we were really on the subject.
Off
now,
the
we've
subject.
Got 66 girls out of 200
yes.
who don't like to show themselves or
right.
are
self-conscious during
they're
sex.
But why are they self-conscious? This is what we should be discussing. And aren't men just as...
Because they have miracle bras.
Yes.
The
and we don't have a miracle jock strap or anything. I mean, right? I mean...
Well.
It's wire.
I think we're all worried about what we look like, but
women more so than men. I think. I think that men look for beauty, physical beauty, in women, and women look more for power or money in men.
Thank God.
But the woman.
I have to take a commercial.
Join us this week on Politically Incorrect when Bill's guests will include the Tonight Show's Jay Leno, actor Paul Sorvino, Third Eye Blind's frontman Stephen Jenkins, and from Sheena, Gina Lee Nolan.
Over 25,000 condoms, it was reported today, have been handed out to the Olympic athletes. But don't worry about promiscuity. I mean, this is the Olympics. They're just using them to smuggle drugs. Okay. Your book is called Pagan Babies. That has very little to do with our next subject, but I like you. I thought I'd plug it again. Actually, maybe it does. Because I want to talk about The Exorcist, which got re-released and did really well at the box office. I remember seeing it when I was 18. I had just begun my life as a lapsed Catholic, and it scared the holy hell out of me. And it was interesting because the Pope did an exorcism last week. Do you realize that? The third one in his 22-year reign, he actually exorcised a teenage girl. And
sounds funny the way you just said that.
Anyway, this girl was, she began screaming insults in a cavernous voice during an audience in Vatican City.
Did it fail? It failed, didn't it?
They did not do it. And the Pope brought his chief Satan buster. I'm not kidding. They called the Father Gabriel Emorth, and they... Yes, it did fail. But I guess, what is scarier, the movie or that people
so
believe
So they send her back to what, the trailer park, and that's it for her?
No. I don't know.
I mean, where did it go?
The thing is that evil does exist in the world, though.
Yes.
I mean, look at Al Gore.
It even exists on the 405 on Friday at 4 o'clock.
Yeah.
Everybody's got it in that car in bumper-to-bumper traffic.
I think it's like the WWF.
I think that
religion's going down, so they do this, go, look, we need like a real, like an evil guy. And so you'll be like the healer with an attitude.